The next step is using our trimmer, and we're going to detail that hairline. I just want to clean up to the hairline. I don't want to stamp in some crazy artificial hairline. I want to use the corner of the tool, and I just want to clean up to that natural line. If you keep it close to natural, it's not going to grow out a few days later and look like two hairlines or hair growing next to a hairline. But you want to have that defined, clean hairline. That's the game changer. You know, you're sealing the deal. Clean up that cheek area around the beard. I want to flip my machine over and stretch that skin and work my way around the ear. You know, it's a bald fade, so we're just going to take it right up to that line. The trimmer gets a little bit closer than the actual zero setting on the clipper. Detail that back corner, stretch the skin. I brush it down, clean up that neck hair, right up to that neckline. We're gonna bald right into it, line off that corner. Notice how I'm holding my tool. Brush it down. I'm not stabbing and dragging, I'm flipping that trimmer around and I'm cleaning up to the balded area that we left off with our clipper. This takes it slightly lower, and when it's balded out, it all grows out at the same pace. You don't have to create a neckline, you don't have to figure out where one lives. Again, edge up that little spot behind the mastoid, flip the machine over, and clean up to the line. You're balding out any of that neck hair. Notice how I'm using the tool. This stretches it out a little bit further from even lighter contrast up into the top length. Make sure you fold down the ear and work your way around. Stretch the skin, use that corner. Brush it down, using the corner to define that beard line. Again, the front hairline. Using the trimmer, and just detailing it, keeping it as natural as possible. I can't stress that enough. Notice the definition. When this grows out, it's still gonna look good. And I'm just curving it and balding out that sideburn area. Dust them off.